August 17th, 1969, a night of terror for many Mississippians. It's the night that Hurricane Camille made landfall on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, devastating the coastline and the pine belt. While forecasting techniques in 1969 were not as advanced as they are today, they were still quite good for the time. Unfortunately, Camille was terribly forecasted. Even 18 hours before landfall, it was expected to curve and go towards Pensacola, not towards the original track it would take towards Pass Christian. Because of this, only a hurricane watch was in effect for Saturday morning into Saturday afternoon, the day before the storm. It wasn't until 15 hours before landfall that the Mississippi Gulf Coast was finally upgraded to a hurricane warning. Radio stations in Biloxi ramped up their coverage to frantically warn of the increasing threat that was coming. Residents in Pass Christian and westward who listened to stations from New Orleans never heard the dire predictions until it was too late. Because of this, fewer than 50% of the population evacuated from the coast. Camille made landfall that night as a Category 5 storm just after 11 p.m. in Pass Christian. Officially, the storm had winds of 175 miles an hour, but other estimates place winds closer to 190 with gusts up to 230. But the exact speed of the winds will never be known since Camille destroyed all of the weather sensors along the coast at landfall. Storm surge reached 24 feet along the Mississippi Gulf Coast, which was the highest storm surge ever recorded until Katrina. Conditions in the Pine Belt went downhill quickly after midnight. The Highway Patrol Post in Hattiesburg estimated winds of 100 miles an hour just before 2 a.m., with trees going down like matchsticks. Around 3:45, the Weather Observer in Columbia estimated winds of 120 miles an hour as the center passed just east of town. Tornadoes also touched down throughout the area, causing damage. Camille weakened and left the area just before sunrise the next day, leaving behind $950 million of damage in Mississippi alone and killing more than 143 people along the Gulf Coast. Today, a memorial stands across the street from the beach in Biloxi to remember all those who were lost that terrible night. For WDAM 7 News, I'm First Alert Meteorologist Patrick Bigbie.